this is it the Shatter Me series? Because the first one is Shatter Me, written by Tahereh Mafi. Definitely pronounced that wrong. But yeah, I only have the first one. Again, this is just one series that I consistently see when I'm scrolling BookTok and stuff, so I was at fantasy romance about a maiden who must unleash the monster within to save her kingdom. See, I was gonna say it's kind of a darker kind of fantasy, but I love the word gothic, so that will be a really good book to get into. So if you're into that sort of thing, I've heard many good things about this one. Just 18-year-old Iris Winnow just wants to hold her family together. Her mother is suffering from addiction and her brother is missing from the front lines. Her best bet is to win the columnist promotion at the Oath Gazette. To combat her worries, Iris writes letters to her brother and slips them beneath her wardrobe door, where they vanish into the hands of Roman Kit, her cold and handsome rival at the paper. When he anonymously writes Iris back, the two of them forge a connection that will follow Iris all the way to the front lines of battle for her brother, the fate of mankind, and love. Divine Rivals is an epic enemies to lovers fantasy novel filled with hope and heartbreak and the unparalleled power of love. So yeah, easy read. So I'm excited to get to that one. Okay, we have 4 series left. Let's do this one quick. So these ones I were in a video recently. This is the Caraval series. I bought these, or 2 of them, in my come book shopping with me video. So the first one, you his choosing. But after Evangeline's first promised kiss, she learns that bargaining with an immortal is a dangerous game and that the Prince of Hearts wants far more than she pledged. He has plans for Evangeline, plans that will either end in the greatest happily ever after or the most exquisite tragedy. So I love books like Making a Deal with the Devil. I didn't realize that was kind of what at least this first one's about, so that's really cool. That kind of reminds me of one of my favorite books of all time, The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue. Love it so much. It's again like Making a Deal with the Devil. That could honestly be in this video, but so there's some. Read that one, The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue. Okay, so two more series. These ones, if you know books, you should know that these were coming. This is A Court of Thorns and Roses, written by Sarah J. Maas. This is the first in a fantasy series. So these are, they get kind of, no, I wouldn't say high fantasy. No, honestly, in my opinion, I think this series is a great one to start out fantasy with. This book, as well as Verity, got me back into reading. I freaking ate this book up. Freaking fell in love with it. So it's about Vera. She's the main protagonist, and her sisters and her father are living in complete poverty. And she ends up killing this wolf, and this wolf slash man ends up, or no, a different wolf slash man comes and kidnaps her and takes her away to the fantasy world. So Vera and her sisters are human, and she ends up being taken away. So I actually didn't realize it while reading it, but it is a like Beauty and the Beast kind of retelling. Only the first book though. Then the other ones are not at all, and they do get a little bit more high fantasy. They are a little bit smutty, honestly. Are just so amazing, and where this book went, I was not expecting at all. I freaking ate this up, loved it, loved this whole series. There are five books in it, and I think actually more are coming out, so 1,000,000% recommend this if you love fantasy, or even if you want to maybe give fantasy a go. Series is also Sarah J. Maas. This is the Throne of Glass series. This one I have yet to read. There are 8 books in this series. I'm collecting all of them before I start them, and I have half of them so far. This series is more high fantasy than A Court of Thorns and Roses, but everyone that I've seen who has read these, absolutely loves them. You kind of get lost in the world, and I hear lots about the characters and falling in love with them and kind of having your favorite characters throughout this series. And what's interesting is 2 of these books, I don't know why or how this happened or why they were written the way they were, but 2 of them people read in tandem. So literally, it's like you're reading 2 books at a time, where you read 1 chapter from this book, 1 chapter from this book, go back, 1 chapter, 1 chapter, 1 chapter, 1 chapter, until you get through both of them. Isn't that crazy?